So now we will discuss about PN junction. So we can obtain a PN junction when a single lattice of pure silicon or germanium is doped with P type from one side and N type from the other side. So we should take a single lattice of pure semiconductor, and from one side we should dope it with a P dopant, and from the other side we should dope it with the N type of dopant. Now this P side and N side, they form two electrodes on the same crystal. When P type meets N type, then what we get is a PN junction. Now let us describe two processes that occur inside a PN junction. First is diffusion, the other is drift. First let us talk about diffusion. Let this be a PN junction. This side is P type doped and this side is N type doped. So it is represented. So these are acceptor negative cores with their associated holes on P side, whereas on N side these are donor cores with associated electrons. Now due to high concentration of holes on P side and high concentration of electrons on N side, they start to diffuse. When they diffuse, the holes and electrons, they recombine at the point where they meet. So electrons diffuse from N side to P side and holes from P side to N side, they recombine and thereby depleting both the charges and causing a depletion region at the center of this PN junction, leaving behind their cores. So this is depletion region. Now negative core, this accumulates on the P side, and positive core accumulates on the N side. Thereby, it creates an electric field. It can be shown here. So, an electric field is generated from N side to P side. This region is called depletion region. Why so? Because charges are depleted. The holes and electrons have recombined, leaving behind their cores, negative on the P side, positive on the N side, and thereby this is electric field from N side to P side. Due to this, this region acts as a fictitious battery. This is not an actual battery, but this region will behave as a fictitious battery because of this electric field. This fictitious battery or this electric field will oppose further diffusion of holes from P side to N side, because any hole that will try to diffuse through this depletion region will be pushed back towards P type, and any electron that tries to diffuse through this depletion region is pushed towards n type. Here it is represented. So, holes are pushed towards p side and electrons are pushed towards n side. Now, the other process is drift. Let us see what is drift. This is fictitious battery Vb and the potential across fictitious battery is called barrier potential. At the instance when diffusion is taking place and depletion region is being formed, at this very time there is breaking of covalent bond due to high temperature inside depletion region. Now, covalent bond between silicon atoms when broken forms equal number of electrons and hole pairs. Due to this electric field, electrons are pushed towards n side and holes are pushed towards p side. This is called drifting. This contributes to a drift current from n side to p side. So, we have seen diffusion current is from p side to n side because of diffusion of holes from p to n and electrons from n to p, while the drift current is from n side to p side. In equilibrium, the drift current is equal to diffusion current and there is no net current across this depletion region. Barrier potential and thickness of depletion region, it depends on few factors. It depends on nature of semiconductor. It is universally it depends on the temperature. Larger the temperature, smaller would be the depletion region and greater would be the conductivity. Similarly, it also depends universally on the concentration of dopants. If the concentration is larger, the thickness of depletion region would be smaller and smaller would be the barrier potential. This is symbol for a p-n junction. This side is anode represented by a triangle. This is a straight line which represents n side and is a cathode. So, p-n junction denotes a diode with one electrode towards p type acting as anode and other electrode towards n type which acts as cathode. Now, let us see how we connect a p-n junction in a circuit. Depending on how it is connected with the terminals of a battery, a p-n junction can be forward biased or it can be reverse biased. When p side of p-n junction is connected to positive terminal of battery and n side is connected to negative terminal of battery, then p-n junction is said to be forward biased. So, this is a forward biased diode. Now, let us see the nature of electric field due to barrier potential and that due to applied voltage. This is electric field due to barrier potential and this is electric field due to applied voltage. We can see both these electric fields oppose each other. Now, due to this, when V applied voltage is greater than barrier potential, holes start to move from P side to N side and electrons start to move from N side to P side. There is diffusion and collision of holes and electrons on this depletion layer. The thickness of this layer or its width gets decreased. So, earlier it was this much wide, but now the width is decreased. So, current starts to flow from P side to N side because of majority charge carriers on P side and on N side. Holes diffuse through potential barrier from P side to N side and electrons from N side to P side. So, this causes a relatively larger amount of current to pass through the PN junction. This current is measured in milliampere and it is increased with increase in temperature. Now, let us see circuit diagram for a forward biased PN junction diode in order to study its VI characteristic. VI characteristic is a plot or graph between potential, applied potential and current obtained. So this is our circuit diagram. This is PN junction diode, here is applied voltage, this is external resistance to control the amount of current through PN junction. A voltmeter is connected in parallel to the diode. This must be noted that voltmeter should always be connected in parallel to PN junction diode, while ammeter is connected in series with PN junction diode. This will help to measure the amount of current flowing through PN junction diode. So, when key is closed and voltage is increased, this is the VI characteristic that is obtained in case of forward biased diode. It is seen that this curve is not a straight line, that means it is non-ohmic, it does not follow Ohm's law. Initially, when potential is increased from 0 to say certain value, it is observed that current is more or less close to 0 ampere. There is no flow of current, but then there is a potential after which the current increases exponentially. This potential is called threshold or cut-in voltage. So, it is that potential at which the resistance across junction becomes negligible. So, on increasing potential, there comes a certain threshold voltage at which resistance across this junction becomes negligible and current increases exponentially. This particular voltage at which current starts to increase exponentially is called threshold or cut-in voltage. For silicon, this cut-in or threshold voltage is 0.7 volt, whereas for germanium it is 0.2 volt. So, this is our VI characteristic for silicon diode. Let us discuss reverse bias. When P side of PN junction is connected to negative terminal and N side is connected to positive terminal of battery, what we get is reverse biased PN junction diode. So this P side is connected to negative terminal and N side is connected to positive terminal. It should be noted that the electric field due to barrier potential and electric field due to applied voltage, they add each other, that is they support each other. Therefore, the majority charge carrier on P side, that's holes, they cannot diffuse through this depletion region. Rather, they are repelled away from depletion region. Similarly, electrons are also repelled away from depletion region and causing increase in width of the depletion region. Therefore, no current flows through PN junction due to majority charge carriers. However, there are minority charge carriers on P side as well as on N side. Electrons are minority charge carriers on P side, whereas holes are minority charge carriers on N side. Electrons start to drift through depletion region, and similarly holes also start to drift through this depletion region. This causes a very small current in a reverse direction opposite to PN junction. This current is due to minority charge carriers and its magnitude is very small. That is why it is measured in microampere. This is called leakage current. It is very small in magnitude and opposite in direction. Now, we have this circuit for obtaining VI characteristic for a reverse bias diode. So, PN junction, the P side is connected to negative terminal and N side is connected to positive terminal of battery. A voltmeter is connected in parallel to PN junction, as I told, in case of forward biased diode, and ammeter is connected in series. When key is closed, very small amount of current start to flow from positive terminal to negative terminal, but opposite across PN junction. The associated plot is represented here. Current is to be measured in microampere because it is very small in magnitude. This is reverse potential. Again, we can see the curve is not a straight line, it is non-linear, therefore it is non-ohmic. Current is small. Why? Because it is due to minority charge carriers only. Then after some time, on increasing potential in reverse direction, at a potential which is called Zener breakdown voltage, which could be anything from 1 to volt to it may be several hundred voltages, we see there is abrupt increase in current. So, this potential is called Zener breakdown voltage.